understand because she's out here by herself. So yeah, go ahead and head on out. We'll get started.
Alrighty, little bees.
Okay. Awesome.
It's time to swarm into the studio as the final countdown begins. The live show is starting in 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Hello, friends. My name is Rick Party, and I want to welcome you to the Killer Bee Studios. Get ready to experience all the buzz of Killer Bee. And don't forget to like the world. Grab a seat, invite your friends, and let's throw some confetti. In 3, 2, 1.
Hey, everybody. Woohoo. Look at this crowd. Yes. Welcome, everyone. So if you're wondering why I'm out here by myself, it's because Mr. KillerB is getting the live stream set up. So I have to keep you occupied. How shall I do that? Who's excited for Christmas? Let's see some confetti. Ooh, and jumping. I love that. Yes. I'm excited too. I can't say I'm exactly ready for it, but I'm going to start working on that next week. That's plenty of time, right? Yes. Okay. Who is excited for these amazing artists that we're going to hear tonight? I cannot wait. You guys have no idea what is in store for you. It's going to be amazing. Look at this. I'm so excited. Hey.
Hey, everybody. I'm here, Mrs. Killer B. Yeah. Oh, hey, hold on a second. Hold on. Okay. I mean, you can.
Where are you?
Hey, I'm here, everybody. There you go. We needed the applause, but
I was floundering, so I'm glad you're here.
Yeah, well, you know, we're trying to do this live stream for the first time. You guys, this is exciting. Woo! I'm so glad you guys are all here. Mrs. Clary did an amazing job. And I want to be honest, I was backstage of everybody and I said, hey, should I just let her kind of keep going and see how far she can keep going with this thing?
Oh,
and they're like,
goodness.
I'm not going to tell you, but some of them said yes. I'm not going to tell you who it was, but
yeah, don't tell me which ones. Yeah, it's okay. I still love all of you back there. It's okay.
Well, we're super excited everybody's here. You know, so I know we have some new. How many people, this is your first time you've been to the Killer Bee Studios? Throw some confetti. Yeah. Hey, I see Metavoice. Metavoice is here. Yes. Metavoice. I think he's kind of like a newcomer now. I think that maybe.
I think we could probably.
Well, okay.
You've been here a time or two.
Yes, we're so excited you guys are all here. How many of you guys are excited about Christmas? How many of you are excited? Throw some confetti. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Like, I see all the Christmas outfits out there.
I know. I love it.
Well, this is awesome. We got a great, you know, we called this event the Christmas experience because I think there's so many things that we probably all hold dear in our lives. And that's why I thought this is a great way to call the Christmas experience. And before we start, I do want to tell you guys, like, if you've never been to the studios, this is a place that we actually host shows every week, starting in January. We've kind of taken some time off in December because we have the Christmas experience tonight. And so we have several different artists that are on the road right now. Some of them are actually in the tour bus that are coming on. We got people from Nashville. We have artists right here from Horizons, from HGT, from Horizons Got Talent. You guys been to Horizons Got Talent? Yeah. Throw some confetti for them. I see Joel's wife out there, Andy Pants. Yes.
I'm guessing
Joel's going to have to explain that to us a little bit later. So, but we're so glad you're here. So glad you're here. Well, if you've never been here before, we do host shows here every week. And come January, we're going to be having multiple shows. But before that, next week, we have another event. If you love to sing Christmas tunes and you have a favorite tune, join us next week on Tuesday at 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. We have a Christmas Caroling Spotlight, which will be hosted by Diener and Don right up here. Throw some confetti for Diener and Don. That's going to be a fun night. So that's going to be a great event as well. But today's event is all about Christmas experience. And we have a Christmas musical experience for you guys tonight. And at the end, there's some people in here that's waiting for this. At the end, we are giving away two Oculus headsets. Oculus 2 headsets that's been autographed by all of our guests since the last time we gave away a headset. And who won the last headset? There was anybody in here that won the last headset? I think it was that guy right there, that Metavoice guy that said it was his first time. Yes.
Keep grabbing this microphone.
Yeah, I know. Here, just here you guys go.
I'm using it right now. It just comes back.
It comes back. It's like a boomerang. But we're giving away two headsets tonight. So if you're in the top 20 of that Hivetivity ranking, you're going to be in for that drawing, and we're giving those away at the end. Now, the way I was explaining to people is that those headsets won't ship out until January because we have to get headsets back in from our guests. So so just give us some time to do that. But we're also going to give away an Amazon gift card as well, and that will be to somebody that's in the audience tonight right here. Yes. So if you're here, just be here at the end of the event, and someone's going to win a $25 gift card to Amazon. So who wants $25 to Amazon? Anybody in here want $25 for Amazon? I feel like I'm auctioning.
Can I win it?
No, you can't win it. We're actually removed from the list. Like, they can't pull our names. It's not fair. It's not fair.
It's so weird seeing your face without the facial tracking. It looks so different.
Do you want me to turn it on? It's kind of weird because I think I might be looking down when I do it.
Nah, I don't know. Okay. Whatever you want.
I do make faces. Okay, hold on a second. Let's just, I'm going to do that. Because anybody watching live, they're not going to see it. Okay. I'll just be looking down sometimes. But okay, is that better?
Yeah, it is.
Okay. All right, cool.
Without facial tracking, really.
Well, and Mrs. Killer B, when you think about what Christmas is, let's go ahead and get started. When you think about Christmas, what is one word that comes to your mind?
Love.
Ooh, love.
For a lot of reasons. Yeah, for a couple reasons, I should say. You know, first of all, like, God's love for us to send Jesus. And then also, like, you know, you get to spend more time with your family at Christmas time, and you get to, you know, show your love for your family members in lots of different ways. You know, as we talked about in another show, gift giving is very important to me. So I get to, like, show my love for you guys with what I give you or make you or buy you, you know. So love. Yeah. Christmas means love to me.
I love that. I love that your word is love.
Love it.
So. I love it. Well, thank you, Mrs. KillerB. Oh, we're going to ask all the guests that come out, what is their one word that kind of comes to their mind when they think about Christmas? And I know some of them
what
are going to share
you,
other
Mr.
things.
KillerB, for me, what about you?
Well, you know, I think for me, okay, do you guys really want to know?
Yeah,
sugar cookies. Sugar cookies.
Sugar cookies.
No, sugar cookies is one thing, but really it's the, it's it just feels like the time of the season, like we're, I guess friendships, like you really get to connect with your friends, and a lot of people are taking off work and you get to spend more time with them than normally you can, because, you know, we're all busy. Yeah. So there's a lot of stuff going on. So I just think of friendship and family. So
I think that makes sense, because since a lot of our friends are still in Ohio and we really only go back at Christmas time, it's kind of a natural connection.
Yes. Yeah. And we just got back from that trip. So,
And
you guys, you know, I can't wait. Like, afterwards, we'd love to hear your guys' words, too. Usually, we do open mics during shows and stuff. But since we have so many things lined up tonight, it's going to be, we're just going to roll with it and let you guys enjoy this Christmas experience together here at the KillerB Studios. So when we talk about Christmas traditions, Arcane, does Mrs. Killer need to be step up closer to the mic? Is she far away from you, or are you good? I know that we have our people streaming here live. Hey, everybody, thanks for watching us live. If you're like, what are we watching, a cartoon? Yeah, kinda. It's the only show I could get. Yeah, we're real people. Real people, yes. Well, we're so glad you guys are here. And if you get headsets, you should definitely join us. So, and Mrs. KillerB, you got to quit throwing the mic. All right. So when we talk about, you know, Christmas experiences, one of those things that come to my mind are traditions, like the traditions that we always love to do. And for me, one of the things that I think about when it comes to Christmas traditions, do you guys, anybody else here in the audience have Christmas traditions you love to do every year? Throw some confetti. Yes. Okay, cool. Awesome. Well, one of my favorite things is I love music. If you guys saw my office space, I have records everywhere. I kind of have an addiction to collecting vinyl records. That's just my thing. All different genres. I love music. I play music. I just love it. And so one of my Christmas traditions is listening to my favorite Christmas tunes. Like, we all have
absolutely
Christmas tunes that hold dear to our hearts. Is there a song particular for you, Mrs. KillerB?
It's a whole album. Biba Norman's Christmas album is just perfection.
Yes. Has anybody here heard of Bebo Norman before?
Don.
Oh, yeah. Joel.
Oh,
yes.
Star
okay.
Fox.
Yes.
Very good.
Oh, Star Fox.
Yeah.
Awesome. Hey, I haven't said anything. I haven't figured it out yet, but I think I might try to do a Bebo Christmas song during the Christmas caroling spotlight.
Yes. So I thought you were going to say, I think Bebo is here.
No, Bebo's not here. He's not here.
Joel is actually Bebo Norman. He looks that's like great. Him.
Well, what I love about this part of the show, we're going to transition and bring up our first guest. Mr.KillerB, if you want to go ahead and go off stage, and we'll go ahead and start going through the Christmas experience. What I love is the first part of this event is going to be us sharing some of those Christmas tunes that we each have hold dear to our hearts. And then we'll transition to phase two of the show in a little while. So we're going to bring up our first singer is all the way from HGT right here from Horizons Got Talent. Her name is Pretty Gal too. If you guys would please, let's throw some confetti for Pretty Gal. Pretty Gal, come on out. Hey, thanks for joining us, Pretty Gal. Thank you. I'm so glad you're here. Oh, you're muted. Just let you know you're muted. And I think I can. Oh, I don't have a button.
Oh, hello, everybody.
Sorry, I keep running like all in front of you like a crazy maniac. But I was looking for, I had a remote somewhere, but it's gone. So, you know, teleported to the metaverse somewhere. But we're so glad you're here, Pretty Gal.
I'm so glad to be here. Thank you for having me.
Yes, it's an honor. And you guys, I want to let you guys know, like, there's a lot of people here that some are here singing tonight that are going through battling sickness right now. There are some of them that couldn't make it because they have sickness. A lot of people we know is getting COVID right now. So be praying for all of them. And I know that I believe you were going through a sickness too. Weren't you, Pretty Gal?
I was not too long ago, but
Okay. Dead. I know like Pink is, there's other people, Jayfish that's going to be joining us tonight. A lot of people, but you know, I'm so glad you guys made it out. I would love to ask you, Pretty Gal, when you think of Christmas, what is the one word that comes to your mind?
Family. And the birth of Christ.
Yes. Amen. I love it. Do you like to spend time with your family during the Christmas time? Do you guys all live in the same state?
No, everybody's kind of everywhere, but yeah. A lot of us do, you know, come together for awesome. Christmas and celebrate. Yes.
Awesome. I love that. I love it. Well, the song that you have that you're going to do tonight is the Christmas song. Is that correct?
Yes. Well, that's Christmas to me.
That's Christmas to you. Okay, awesome. Yes. Is there a particular reason, like a reason behind why you love this song?
Yes, it explains, like, you know, the joy of family and just different things that everybody love about Christmas. It's something in the song that you will love, you know.
Awesome. Well, thank you so much. I'm going to get out of the way and let you take it over, Pretty Gal. Everybody, let's throw Pretty Gal some confetti as she gets ready to lead us in this first Christmas experience musical.
Thank you. The fireplace is burning bright, shining all on me. I see the presents underneath, a good old Christmas tree. Wait all night till Santa comes to wake me from my dreams. Oh, why is this Christmas to me? To see the children play outside like angels in the snow. When mom and daddy share a kiss under the mistletoe. And we cherish all these simple things. Whatever we may be, oh, why? 'Cause there's Christmas to me. I've got this Christmas song in my heart. I've got the candles glowing in the dark. I'm hanging all the stockings by the Christmas tree. Oh, why? 'Cause there's Christmas to me. Oh, why, that's Christmas to me. I listen for the thud of reindeers walking on the roof. As I fall asleep to lullabies, the morning's coming soon. The only gift I'll ever need is the joy of family. Oh, why, 'cause there's Christmas to me. I've got this Christmas song in my heart. I've got the candles glowing in the dark. I'm hanging all the stockings by the Christmas tree. Oh, why, that's Christmas to me. Oh, why, that's Christmas to me. I've got this Christmas song in my heart. I've got the candles glowing in the dark. I'm hanging all the stockings by the Christmas tree. Oh, why, that's Christmas to me. I've got this Christmas song in my heart. I've got the candles glowing in the dark. I'm hanging all the stockings by the Christmas tree. Oh, why, that's Christmas to me. Oh, why, that's Christmas to me.
Thank you.
Oh, that was awesome. That was incredible for you. Like, I got to get this big cannon out here to shoot out there. I don't have snow, but here, let me rain you with some confetti. So that was incredible. Wow.
Thank you
so much for sharing that with us today and letting us hear a little bit of your story behind your Christmas experience. What does Christmas mean to you? Like, when you think of Christmas, what does it mean to you?
It means joy. Yeah. Like, it's always happy seeing other people with their families and seeing people, you know, in the stores shopping. And it's just a joyous time.
I love it. You know, I was just talking to somebody on our Discord, and let you guys know, we have a Discord. If you can see it up there, if you just go to discord.killerbstudios.com, you can join it for free. But someone, I was asking the question in there about, like, what's one word? And someone said joy. And they said, you always ask hard questions. So I said, okay, well, that's great, because I got another one for you right now. Why joy? And they were talking about how this time of seasons, people seem to be nicer. Like, they try to be nicer and have that joy. And I was talking to them. I said, you know, it's interesting. I was reading a book. Me and Mrs. Killer B has been reading a book, and it was talking about the Sabbath day. And it said, what happened if we approach the Sabbath day, you know, that day of rest, like we do every holiday? We prepare to unplug, to slow down, and really just enjoy, have that joy in that moment and today. So I love that you shared that. So thank you so much, Pretty Gal. Thank you guys. Let's everybody throw some confetti for Pretty Gal. Yes, awesome. Pretty Gal, how can people connect with you outside of Horizons?
I'm on Instagram. It's prettygal2_VR.
Awesome. Awesome. Well, thank you so much. Thank you so much, Pretty Gal.
Thank you for having me.
All right.
Thank
yes. Thank you. Thank you. And make sure you hang around. We can do a selfie together for everybody. So our next guest, you guys, the next guest we're going to bring up is another HGT alumni. I think that was the word I saw you using earlier. The alumni is from HGT, and it is J-Fish. So J-Fish, if you want to come on out, everybody, let's throw J-Fish some confetti. J-Fish, come on out. Hey, dude. And I love what kind of coat do you call this? It's like one of those like puffy coats.
I refer to it as the free one.
The free one, huh? I love it. I love it. You can tell I got this
down,
one free.
I don't know. I mean, VR down, whatever.
I mean, this jacket looks free, right? I mean, this
looks good.
Oh, really? Okay. All right. Respect. I think I saw this one at our local thrift store, thrift store, we get some pretty good clothes at thrift store, so I'm not ashamed about that. My wife and Arcane gets better than me, but thank you so much for joining us, J-Fish. I'm going to keep rambling, and people aren't here to hear that. So, J-Fish, when it comes down to a word that comes to your mind when you think of Christmas, what is it for you?
I always think of the word hope. It means a lot to me in my life and so many others, especially if anybody who has a news feed on their phone gets to see the state of this world and stuff going on. Christmas is to me about better days ahead, and the hope for better things in the middle of the mess that is out there. Yeah.
Amen. I love that. That's so good. When I think that's something we definitely need during this time of the season. You know, we have joy, but we can also get kind of overwhelming. I know a lot of us, not everybody for Christmas is joy. That's not a word that they feel, but they need that hope that there's something better. And so, like, when it comes to the meaning of Christmas, what does Christmas mean to you?
Yeah, I think it's wrapped up in that, in amidst the brokenness and trials and troubles. Let's see, it's claimed the birth of Jesus, and a way and a hope, some truth, some life, and more than just what we see with our eyes, but beyond it. So, I mean, I'm no one who could come up here and preach an amazing sermon, but I definitely know that without Jesus, without hope, without faith, without the love that I've experienced through him, I'd be a much different person. And again, it's easier to talk from a place of brokenness than have it together. But that's why it matters, and that's why this season matters, to remember the gift we were given, I guess.
Amen. Thank you, Jay Fish. Thank you. So your song tonight, if I have it right here on the list, you're doing Better Days. And I don't think I need to ask you why. So I think I'm just going to turn it over to you, Jay Fish. Thank you, guys.
I didn't plan that, by the way.
Yeah. Well, hey, it felt right.
Yeah,
in the
place. I did plan that. Very
you did
thoughtful.
Plan that. Yeah. Yeah. Very thoughtful. Very thoughtful. Everybody, let's throw some confetti for Jay Fish as he gets ready to sing Better Days. And thank you, Jay.
Thanks, friends. Absolutely.
And you ask me what I want this year. I try to make it kind and clear, just the chance that maybe we'll find better days. 'Cause I don't need boxes wrapped in strings and designer moving empty things, just the chance that maybe we'll find better days. So take these words and sing out loud, 'cause everyone is forgiven now. 'Cause tonight's the night the world begins again. Someplace simple that we could live, and it's something only you can give, and that's faith and trust and peace while we're alive. And the one poor child who saved this world, there's 10 billion more who probably could. We don't just stop and said a prayer for them. So take these words and sing out love, 'cause everyone is forgiven now. So take these words and sing out loud, 'cause everyone is forgiven now. Oh, tonight, tonight, the world begins again. Yeah, tonight, tonight, the world begins again. I wish everyone was loved tonight, and somehow stop this endless fight. Just a chance and maybe we'll find better days. I wish everyone was loved tonight, and somehow stop this endless fight. Oh, the chance and maybe we'll find better days, days, days. So take these words and sing out loud, 'cause everyone, the one, forgive it now. 'Cause tonight's the night the world begins again. And I celebrate the day that you were born to die, that someday I would pray to you to save my life. Holy night, and all is calming, and all is made bright, round yon virgin, mother and child. And holy infant soul, tender and mild, and sleep in heavenly peace, and sleep in heavenly peace.
That was amazing, Jay Fish. Thank you so much, man. I love that. I love how you put and brought Silent Night right into that. What a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful song.
Pleasure being here.
Yes, pleasure having you. Thank you so much. Everybody, let's throw some confetti for Jay Fish. Thank you so much. All right, so our next, like, you guys, make sure you guys hang around because we definitely want you guys to hang out, get to know all the artists that's here tonight. It's so wonderful that they took the time to be able to make this work tonight. So again, a lot of them are, some of those people that are here tonight performing are going through sickness. And as I bring out our next artist, this is one of our featured artists. We're going to bring out Damien Horne. So Damien, come on out if you guys want to throw some confetti. So just to let you know, Damien, hey, I love it. Like, you look, he's, you guys don't know this, but he, like, I dressed his avatar. That kind of sounds weird, right? Sounds a little weird. But Damien, you got to understand, like, the first time that we started bringing guests in, Damien is one of the artists here from Nashville that I connected with him. I said, hey, would you mind to come in here in Metaverse and be a part and do a Christmas show? And he's like, yeah, why not? He's like, did you think I was crazy at first? What was your initial thoughts?
This is my first experience with all of this. So I'm just trying not to get motion sickness.
Yeah, I get it. Totally good. Well, here, why don't you step up here to the mic a little bit closer so people can see you better, and I'll get out of your way. I'll just kind of stand here and I'll talk to you from here. So because you know how we all know, like, meta age, and this is something new. So Damien is brand new. He's never been in here, everybody. This is his first time. So his meta age is about an hour right now. So it's very, and he didn't get as much training as we usually give new people coming in because we had like four or five people to kind of walk through to get everything ready. So, Damien, you are very brave to step up here. So I really appreciate it. But our first person I dressed in avatar, they did not like how I dressed them. And I tried my hardest. So I've gotten better. Mrs. Killer B says I've gotten better. And you see, you guys don't know this, but he stayed with the outfit. Probably it just, he didn't know how to change it yet is really what it comes down to. But
no, I dig it. I really dig it. I love it.
Awesome. Yeah, that's right, guys. I'm hip. You hear that, Arcane? See, that's my son right there. That's running the live stream camera. So he's I'm hip. Well, Damien, I'm so glad that you come out. And you guys, I reached out to him like right before the event about his songs. And I was like, hey, I already knew that one of the songs he's going to do later. And I was asking him about a second song, and I started looking through his Spotify. Make sure you guys check out, you know, I know Damien and Joel both have Spotify's. Check them out. Some of the artists, other artists here, like Jay Fish, you should definitely connect with them on Instagram. They might have Spotify's too. I haven't looked that far, but I started digging through your Spotify's because I'm like, what song could I request for you to sing? And I thought this was perfect. And I was like, I don't know. I told Mrs. Killer B, I was like, this is last minute. You know, Christmas songs are sometimes those songs that you do rarely, like once a year, right? So right. I'm like, I don't know how long it's been since he's done this song. You're still doing the song, right? Did I ask to make sure?
Before I am. Okay, cool.
Okay. Before I go too far in this. And I thought this is a perfect song for tonight because not only, you know, during the Christmas time, I know it's not always joy. It can be heavy sometimes. And I know that we have people that couldn't make it here tonight thank God that we had live stream. Like, we didn't have this. This is the first time we've been able to do this. So I was glad that we're able to do that. But these people started reaching out and said, I have COVID. And some people have the flu. And so all this is going around, and they were disappointed because they couldn't make it. And they've been waiting for this tonight. So we're like, we can live stream. You guys go watch the live stream, catch it that way. But Damien has a song called COVID Christmas.
Yes,
and
indeed.
I was like, this is perfect. So all you people that are watching that couldn't make it, that have COVID or some kind of sickness, I hope you'll find some joy and some humor in this song too. But we also can probably all here relate to some way to this song. So I'm glad you're going to do it for us tonight. But before you jump into that, what is one word that comes to your mind, Damien, when you think of Christmas?
The first word that kind of comes to my mind is others. And I think because of that, you know, like, you know, Thanksgiving is always kind of the time where my family gets together. So that's where usually where I think more family. But Christmas time, my immediate family, we always try to find a way to give back in some kind of way. And it just kind of reminds me of, you know, our Savior coming. He gave his life for us. You know, the Magi, the, you know, wise men who came and brought their gifts. And so during that time, I try to think about others because, you know, as growing up, so many people had did that for myself. So.
Oh, that's amazing. I love that. I love that. Isn't that a beautiful word? Others. I love that. Damien, just to let you guys know, Damien is going to be coming back up. We're going to have Damien do a song. Joel's going to come up, and we're going to bring them back up in the second half with another singer from HGT. As we get ready to do that, I would love to, and I just had, like, my mind just went somewhere. Oh, I was going to tell you, everybody, Damien here is actually going to be one of our first guests coming in January to do one of the shows with us. So he's going to come. We're going to hear his story and talk to him. So make sure you guys come back in January. I'll have to check the date. I think I'll check. I'm not going to say it out loud because I don't remember. But we'll check the date. We'll put it out on the calendar. But with that, Damien, thank you so much for jumping up here, saying I'm going to take a chance at this. You can step up to the mic here. Just kind of step up to the mic and face this way. And then that way he can get you on the camera. And there you go. I'm just helping him get in line. I'm like landing airplanes right here. Right here. I need some of those orange cones. You are perfect, man. So whenever you're ready. All right. You guys throw some confetti for Damien. Great. He's probably getting his guitar right now. So Damien, if for some reason you can hear us, but you're like, I don't know what happened on your right controller. There is a button right below your joystick. It has a circle on it. Press that. You might be in your menu, or you might have stepped out of your safe zone. So if you press that circle button, if you hit that button, it'll bring you back in. Let's see. This is the beautiful thing about when somebody's the first time in here. I'm gonna go backstage now. I know his battery's not dead because we checked. He was charged. So let me... Let me give him a call real quick, make sure he is good. I'm just going to call him real quick, make sure he's good. It's been forwarded to voicemail. All right, so Damien, if you can hear me, if you're in the middle of a menu screen right now, what I need you to do is on your right controller, look underneath your right joystick. You'll see a B and an A button. There's a button that's kind of dented in. It looks like an O. Press that button. That should bring you back in if you're coined out. But if we're coined out, can you guys still hear me when I'm coined out?
Yes.
Okay. So we can't hear him. So I wonder if his headset, something happened. So let's see. What we're going to do as we wait for Damien to come back in. Oh, wait a minute. Are you there, Damien? Thought I heard him. Okay. So what we're going to do while we're waiting for Damien, I'm guessing he's probably having technical difficulties. I'm going to open up Instagram. We're going to go ahead and bring up our next guest, and we'll bring Damien back up here to do his COVID Christmas. I just want to get this open so I can see him if he messages me. Actually, let me call him on Instagram. Let's see if that works. This is a new thing. All right. So, all right, let's go ahead and bring up Joel. Joel, can you come on up, join us up here on stage?
Howdy.
Hey, thanks for joining us, Joel. Damien will be he's like claiming your spot right here. It's like he's like right here in your face.
I'm sorry.
Can you stand like right behind his coin and can you do the COVID Christmas song for us while he's
I don't know the COVID Christmas song, or I totally would.
I think it has a lot of coughing, sniffling, and
Okay.
Oh, there he is. Oh, he's back. Oh, there he is.
All right.
Hold on.
I'll go.
Get out of here, Joel. Get out of here, Joel. All right.
Bye.
did your battery, was you playing music? Oh, hold on, Damien. Come on back up here. Oh, walk around this way.
Where are we?
There you go. Come on up here.
Sorry.
That's all right. You're fine. We lost you there for a second. So are you good now? Are you ready to do the COVID Christmas? Okay, cool.
Oh, yeah. I was doing it. Oh, look.
Oh, you're doing it. Okay. So you have to leave the headset on.
Okay.
Okay. So if you got the headset on, you can tilt it up a little bit if you need to be able to see it. Just tilt the front up.
Okay. Am I there?
Yeah, I think you're good. Let's hear. Can you guys hear his guitar? Strum your guitar. Let's see. Yep, we got you. All right. Let's go for it. All right. Sorry, it's COVID Christmas time. We're so glad because Joel was going to try to steal it and make it his own, but I told him that I think he had copyrights on it. So.
Okay, here we go. This is COVID Christmas. Year I'll spend the holidays alone. There will be no need for mistletoe. Tell Santa please stay 6 feet from my home. Don't wanna give poor Rudolph a runny nose. 'Cause I've been locking coughing in my room ever since the doc gave me the news that I got COVID for Christmas this year. Now my sense, taste, and smell has suddenly disappeared. I got COVID for Christmas, it's clear. We've been spreading more than Christmas cheer. I got a fireside fever with the chills, and my head hurts when I hear those jingle bells. Instead of hanging decorations from my tree, all I wanna do is go to sleep. Dear Santa, if I made your naughty list, I'd gladly take my lump of coal, anything but this. 'Cause I got COVID for Christmas this year. Now my sense of taste and smell suddenly disappear. I got COVID for Christmas, it's clear. We've been spreading more than Christmas cheer. All I said that wearing masks made it feel more like Halloween. Just joking with some friends of mine, it's like the joke's on me. 'Cause I got COVID for Christmas this year. Now my sense of taste and smell have suddenly disappeared. I got COVID for Christmas, it's clear. We've been spreading more than Christmas cheer.
Ooh, I love it. That was awesome. I mean, I don't want... Oh, we're playing like guest music. Just hit that guest music again. One more time. There we go. We're like... Bring him out. Now, that was amazing. That was amazing, Damien. I loved it. Did you guys like that? Like, well, I think it's such a good laugh. How many of you can relate to having COVID at Christmas or any time of the year? It's never a gift you want. When you wrote that song, I'm taking it, you had COVID.
Yeah, actually, I didn't, but my wife had COVID during that time. And it just kind of got her down. And I figure like, man, maybe write something kind of cool and fun. It's just kind of lighthearted to kind of like, you know, I feel like humor is the best medicine. So
yes,
a good, you know, remedy.
Oh, I love it. I mean, me and Mrs. KillerB, so it was two Christmases ago, we were in Ohio because we live in Central Florida, but we travel back to Ohio every Christmas to spend Christmas with our family. And when we were there, she got COVID, I got COVID, and Arcane got COVID. We all three got COVID. And I know I had it for 24 days. I think you were 7 and you were like 2 or 3. It was crazy. But when I heard that song, I was like, man, what a great song for the people. If you guys are watching this live stream, that song was for you. And I hope that it put a smile on your face. Cause I think you're right. You know, laughter is a great medicine. And I thank you so much, Damien, for doing that song for us today. We're going to bring you back here in just a little bit. Everybody, let's throw some confetti for Damien. Thank you so much, Damien. All right, guys. So we're going to bring up our next guest. Our next guest is actually on a tour bus right now. He literally come in. I don't think his battery's died yet. If you wave over there to Andy Pants, you see Andy Pants? Andy Pants, that's his wife over there. And she's not even at the tour bus. She's at her house. I think they're all totally separate right now, but they're able to come in here and join us in virtual reality. So let's go ahead and welcome out Joel one more time. Joel, actually, we'll welcome out 2 more times. But hey, welcome back, Joel.
It's good to see you again.
It's good to be here. So you're in a tour bus right now. You just got off stage, and now you're coming right in here to do a Christmas show with us.
Yeah, I literally did an opening set, played one of the songs already I'm about to play, and the show started 10 minutes late, and I got kind of nervous. I was wondering, am I going to make it? Because I've been fighting with internet connection issues all day long, and I was like, where can I get the best internet? And they were like, probably the bus. And I was like, well, is anybody on there sleeping? Because there's like 12 bunks in a tour bus. I don't know if y'all know that. Nobody's on here. It's just me in this bus right now. Unless there's somebody who snuck in here and is videoing me on this VR making fun of me, which would be hilarious.
That would be good.
But yeah, I'm sitting alone in a tour bus, but I'm hanging out with you guys here in the Metaverse. So,
you know, I loved the last time that Joel was one of our guests just, a couple months ago, I think, maybe even a month ago.
Yeah, house.
Yeah, he was at his house, and this is great. I saw a picture we posted on Instagram. His son was sticking his stinky shoe right underneath your nose when you're
I had no idea. And my wife, Andy Pants over there, she was videoing it the whole time, laughing at me.
So at least it wasn't Andy's pants. At least it was Andy's shoe.
Yeah, it could have been so much worse.
It could have been so much worse. But we had that was a great time with you coming and sharing your story. If you guys haven't heard it, just go to killerbstudios.com. You can go to the podcast and find the podcast episode with Joel Vaughn sharing his story. But Joel, we're so glad that you came. I'm sure when you told your buddies, you know, that you're, how many people did you tell you were coming in here to do this, and what was their response?
The tour manager was like, she saw me sitting with it today and with the headset on, and she said, that is the weirdest thing I've ever seen. And I was like, you can't knock it until you try it.
That's right. Whoop.
And then a lot of people have been like, wait, what are you doing? And then our monitor engineer, he walked on the bus supposedly to go to the restroom. And I'm like, you can't go to the restroom anywhere else in the venue that we're at. So I straight up know he was taking pictures to make fun of me, but it's great. It's great.
That's great. That's great. Well, that's awesome. Well, that's cool. Well, I'm so glad you're here.
I'm glad to be here.
So Joel, when it comes to a word that comes to your mind at Christmas, what would be your one word?
You do ask hard questions. Those are
you know,
like,
what? You know what?
Esoteric.
Give me 1.5 words. And I would like it to be within 11 characters.
Okay. happiness. I keep hitting my guitar. Sorry. Oh, there's a mic. And laughs. Happiness and laughs.
And laughs.
Yeah.
I love it. So why happiness and laughs?
Because I spend a whole lot of my year dealing with things that don't make me happy and things that don't make me laugh. And and Christmas is that time of the year where we all come together and we spend time with our families and our friends. And we get to, one of the things I love to do just in general in life is laugh, and mostly to laugh at myself and kind of make fun of myself, because one, it beats other people to the punch. But two, it's just good for the soul, you know, and God gave us a sense of humor for a reason. And I like to use it.
Amen.
I like to feel
happy. we love seeing your family loves to use it too, because I love the pictures.
Absolutely.
I can't wait to see what comes out of this. We don't know what we're gonna see. And make sure your manager, you can tell him just to send them to me on Facebook. I can give you my email or whatever.
Yeah,
you know, we can make posters and stuff. Make some Joel t-shirts with with you sniffing weird things like Andy's pants. All right. Well,
yeah, we should make a t-shirt out of that.
The song that you're going to open up with tonight, the first one you're going to do is it, if I'm correct, it's beginning to look a lot like Christmas. Is that
Absolutely.
Right?
Absolutely. Yeah.
And is this song dear to you for any particular reason?
It's just a fun song, bro.
Yeah.
I've been opening up, I've done a Christmas tour every year for the last, I think, 4 years now. And I've either opened the tour with that or I've put it somewhere in the middle. And it's just, by the time we hit that song, like one, the kids get involved and they sing it. Like tonight, I had probably 40 kids in the front row just screaming it. I was like, okay, I didn't know children knew this song that well. But it's just a great song to have fun and come together and sing about the joy of Christmas.
Amen. Well, if you want to get positioned here by the mic, yeah, if man. You get ready, I'm going to ask everybody with some confetti, how many of you guys love this song? It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas. All right, look at all that confetti. So as you're getting ready to sing, Joel, I would love to ask you, when do you start listening to Christmas music? When is too early for you?
Probably, like for me, I like to wait till after Thanksgiving.
Okay. All right.
I'm not the early Christmas guy, which kind of is bad for me because they like us CCM guys to be thinking about Christmas in like January.
That's true. Well, thank you so much. I'm going to go ahead and turn it on over to you, and let's go ahead. And you guys, let's throw some confetti for Joel.
See if I can get positioned here in front of this microphone and not forget my lyrics. All right. This is a fun one because it has a lot of lyrics. Y'all hear that okay?
Yep, sounds great.
You can't respond back to me, but... All right, here we go.
It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas everywhere you go. Take a look at the 5 and 10. It's glistening once again with candy canes and silver lanes aglow. It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas. Soon the bells will ring, and the things that'll make them ring is the carol that you sing right within your heart. A pair of hop-along boots and a pencil that chooses the witch of Barney and Ben. Dolls that'll talk and we'll go for a walk is the hope of Janice and Jen. And Mom and Dad can hardly wait for school to start again. It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas. Soon the bells will start, and the thing that'll make them ring is the carols that you sing right within your heart. Pair of hop-along boots and a pistol that shoots is the witch of Barney and Ben. Dolls that'll talk and we'll go for a walk is the hope of Janice and Jen. And Mom and Dad can hardly wait for school to start again.
Am I right?
Yeah.
It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas everywhere you go. There's a tree in the Grand Hotel, one in the park as well. It's the sturdy kind that doesn't mind the snow. It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas. Soon the bells will start, and the thing that'll make them ring is the carols that you sing right within your heart. Within your heart.
Woo-hoo! Woo-hoo! Yeah, I love
thank
it.
You.
That was incredible. That was great, Joel. Joel, thank you so much, man. You're just like goodness. Like I saw people writing, killed it up there. I saw that. That was awesome. Aww. Thank you so much for opening us up with that song. We're gonna bring Joel back here in just a little bit. Let's everybody throw some confetti for Joel. Thank you, Joel. You can take a peek out your headset and make sure nobody's making you sniff anything weird. And we'll bring you back.
I heard somebody open the tour bus door. I think we're good.
Okay. All right. We'll bring Joel back up here in just a minute. So thank you so much, Joel. All right, everybody, you know, this has been so much fun so far. You know, we're getting ready to transition to phase two and of the show, of the Christmas experience. And are you guys having a good time right now? Let's throw some confetti. You guys having a good time? Oh, hold on. You know what? Mrs. KillerB, you watch them. I'm going to turn around so I know, like, they're just going to do that. Is everybody having a good time? You guys can throw confetti now.
Woohoo!
Yep. I still, okay. They're still throwing. Okay. I just want to make sure it wasn't just because I was watching, but you guys, thank you guys so much. This is awesome. We love doing this for you guys. I'm so good. You guys throw some confetti for the artists. They're doing such an amazing job. This is our Zumba. Is that what it's called? Exercise. Mrs. Kilby, come on out here and join me. Is that what this is called? Like Zumba or something? Like when we're doing these arm lifts?
I don't think Zumba's like that, but I could be wrong.
Okay, is yoga? Is it yoga? No, okay. Well, I'm just making you guys exercise. You know, we talked about sugar cookies earlier. This is kind of helps with that. And yeah. I wore this nice jacket that kind of fluffs out. So you can't tell the weight I put on during.
It does fluff out, yeah.
It does, doesn't it?
It's very hobo-esque.
Like the guy from Polar Express on the top of the train?
Exactly, yeah. Like that.
Yeah. Yes, yeah. I should have made the hat black, like the Christmas Santa hat. So, well, you guys,
some dirt smudges on your face.
Some dirt smudges. I could have done that. You can do that now. Oh, really? I wanted to bring up Mrs. Killer B during this next part, but to talk about, you know, there's so many fun traditions and stuff at Christmas time, and we love all that. Like we love, you know, we just getting back home from going to see our family in Ohio. We always love going back to see our friends and family. It feels like we're running around 100 miles per hour the whole time trying to get all that done. Mm-hmm. And you can never get enough time with everybody. You just can't. Yeah. It's so hard. But one of the things that is one of our favorite traditions, which we haven't been able to do for a while now, because it's just there's an event. Has anybody here heard? You can throw some confetti to let me know. Has anybody here heard of the Behold the Lamb of God Christmas tour? It's a concert. It's a Christmas concert. Throw some confetti if you've ever heard of it. Okay. It is, if you've ever wanted to experience a Christmas concert, an event, it's by an artist named Andrew Peterson. He's also an author. Amazing. One of the most amazing Christmas experiences that we've ever had. And it's something we always look forward to every year. And we haven't been able to go for a while because it's just not in the area.
Yeah, it doesn't come to our area anymore. Yeah.
It just, it doesn't. But one of my favorite parts about that show is Andrew reads a part from a book. And Ms. Kilber, you want to share a little bit about what he does, like what I'm talking about there?
So every year he starts off the part of the concert so the whole point of Behold the Lamb of God is that he starts telling the story of Jesus' birth, starting even back in the Old Testament. So it's really, it's beautiful, it's powerful, it's amazing. But he starts that part with a reading from the Jesus Storybook Bible, which if you have not read is life-changing. Honestly, it's a children's book, but it is so beautifully written. And actually, I would love to read a selection from that if that's cool with everybody. Yeah.
Would you guys love for her to read a part of it and throw some confetti? Yeah. Okay. Awesome. Yeah, I would love to. So, Mrs. Killer B, step a little bit closer to the mic here, and I'm going to get out of your way.
Okay. I'm not, listen, I have to lift up my headset just a bit, so make sure that I don't go away from you.
Okay. Lift it up a little bit, and let's see if we can still hear you, because I know you're on the older headset right now. So, let's make sure we can hear you good.
Can you hear me right now?
Yeah. Can you guys hear?
You can all hear me? Okay.
Yep. We're good.
I think I can see pretty well. Okay. All right.
You're not allowed to cry during this, right?
That is not a possibility. I mean, I'm definitely going to cry.
Okay. All right. I'll look for another reader next year, guys. I'm sorry. I'll look for another reader next year. But
yeah,
you do your
anybody
best.
Who can read beautiful things without crying, you are welcome here.
No, okay. Would you tell them again one more time, what is this book called? Because you guys, all joking aside, this is an amazing book. Even it is a children's book. And I love the scripture that talks, you know, we talk about becoming more childlike.
Yeah.
And I for a while, I started reading more children's books. And I'm like, man, we make things so complicated. But I read some of these children books. I'm like, man, these children books are an eye opener sometimes. Like we can overthink things so much. And this, what is it called again?
It's called the Jesus Storybook Bible. It's by Sally Lloyd-Jones.
Look it up. It's on Amazon. It is an amazing, amazing book. Definitely get it. I loved reading it. Mrs. Kilby, I'm going to hand it all over.
The illustrations are amazing. I mean, amazing.
They are.
So this
I'm going to hand it over to you.
Very small selection I'm going to read to you, but it'll give you an idea of what this storybook is like. Okay. This section is called He's Here. Everything was ready. The moment God had been waiting for was here at last. God was coming to help his people, just as he promised in the beginning. But how would he come? What would he be like? What would he do? Mountains would have bowed down. Seas would have roared. Trees would have clapped their hands, but the earth held its breath. As silent as snow falling, he came in. And when no one was looking, in the darkness he came. And there in the stable, amongst the chickens and the donkeys and the cows and the quiet of the night, God gave the world his wonderful gift. The baby that would change the world was born, his baby son. Mary and Joseph wrapped him up to keep him warm. They made a soft bed of straw and used the animal's feeding trough as his cradle. And they gazed in wonder at God's great gift, wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger. Mary and Joseph named him Jesus. Emmanuel, which means God has come to live with us. Because, of course, he had. My controllers are backwards.
You can go ahead and go up and do your song now. Oh, I'm introduced yesterday. Thank you, Mrs. KillerB. I forgot I was like trying to push her other guest out here because this is such a beautiful song to follow up that with. And I forgot I hadn't introduced her yet. So I got to come out here.
And
sorry about that.
My controller's backwards, so I couldn't make my stealthy exit like I wanted to.
Yeah, I had that like that smooth transition and it didn't go so smooth. But
that's okay.
That's the part about live shows. You guys, wasn't that just a beautiful story? You know, it really touched me whenever you said the part two about the snow falling, because you look out here in the snow, it kind of helps put you in that place when you're out here. We're in Florida, so we don't see this. So seeing snow here in virtual reality is pretty cool. Our next guest from HGT is Pink. I believe it's, okay, I got to remember. I got to look at the name. Pink Ice, right? Okay, come on out. I see the word. Pink Ice Diamond. Yes, there you go. Pink Ice, thank you so much for joining us. Thank you so much. Sure. When I say, what is one word that describes Christmas to you?
Jesus.
I don't think you can say it any better than that. Pink Dice, I would love for you, if you would love, I know you have a song for us. You're going to open us up. We're transitioning now to what I call like the Christmas experience, like what the Christmas experience is all about, really what it's all about. And all that joy can come from Jesus. So would you please go ahead and open us up with your song?
Sure.
Who would imagine a king?
Mommies and daddies always believe that their little angels are special indeed, and you can grow up to be anything. But who would imagine a king? A shepherd or teacher is what you could be. Or maybe a fisherman out on the sea. Or maybe a carpenter building things. But who would imagine a king? It was so clear when the wise men arrived and the angels were singing his name, that the world would be different 'cause you were alive. That's what heaven stood still to proclaim. One day an angel said quietly that soon he will bring something special to me. And of all the big wonderful gifts he could bring,
Thank you all so much.
Thank you, Pink. That was beautiful. Thank you so much. And I'm so sorry that I was awkwardly trying to push you off stage.
No, that's okay. I understood. Thank you so much.
No, thank you guys so much. Hey, Pink, how can people connect with you outside of Horizon?
You can find me on Instagram at Pink Ice Diamond VR.
Awesome. Thank you, Pink. All right, everybody, let's throw some confetti for Pink as
Thank
we get
so
ready
much.
To bring back out our guest, one of our featured guests here, Damien. If Damien Horne can come back out here, we'll bring Damien back up, and we're going to go ahead, and he's going to do a Christmas medley. Now, so just give you kind of a funny insight here. I actually was talking to Mrs. KillerB. I was like, he's going to do a Christmas melody. She's like, what do you mean Christmas melody? What song? I was like, a Christmas melody. And actually, I texted it to you like that. She's like, you sure it says melody? Is that medley? I was like, it is medley. That makes more sense. So yeah, that makes a lot more sense. So thank you again, Damien, for joining us. I'll turn it over to you.
Okay, awesome.
Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth receive her King. Let every heart prepare him room, and heaven and nature sing. And heaven and nature sing, and heaven and nature sing. Oh, little town of Bethlehem, how still we see thee lie above thy deep and dreamless sleep. The silent stars go by, yet in thy dawn street shineth the everlasting light. The hopes and fears of all the years are met in thee tonight. The first Noel, the angels did say, was to set in poor shepherds in fields as they lay, in fields where they lay keeping their sheep on a cold winter's night that was so deep. Noel, born is the King of Israel. Oh, come all ye faithful, joyful and triumphant. Oh, come ye to Bethlehem. Come and behold him, born the King of angels. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him, Christ the Lord. 'Cause he rules the world with strength and grace, and makes the nations prove the glory of his righteousness. And one
wonders of his love, and wonders of his love, and wonders of his love.
That was amazing. That was amazing. That is a cool medley. I've never heard. How many songs was wrapped up in that medley there?
I think it was like four, but I can kind of go on for days and days. A lot of them kind of can fit in that groove. So
that's cool. Well, Christmas songs can be such a challenge, such challenging songs to do musically. And I never would have thought that they would have fit so well together like that. So I love that. That was awesome. Thank you, Damien. Thank you so much. So you got Damien, let everybody know how they can connect with you outside of Horizons.
You can find me under my name, Damien Horne, on all social media platforms. And I also have a website called DamienHorne.com. So it's DamienHorne, Horn with an E, like Lena Horne, you know, so yeah.
Yeah. And Damien, okay, so I know I was talking about your Spotify and stuff too. I'm sorry, my hands are doing weird things. So I'm dropping my controllers, but I'm double jointed. See, like this is like a double jointed thing. You can just do like that. I would love to ask you, I was checking out your Spotify for Damien Horne. Now, do you have another group too because I found some other
I
songs
do. I'm actually a part of a trio called the Magi, which is, we tour and play a lot, but I'm glad you said that, because I definitely want to promote that. Those guys are awesome, and it's kind of a trio thing, and it's just three guys who come together, man, and want to put like positive music out in the world. So,
I love it, man.
We're like a middle-aged boy band, so it's fun.
I love it. You guys definitely got to check out his stuff on Spotify, especially. It's the Magi, is that right?
The Magi, M-A-G-I. So you can find us at the Magi Music.
Yes, it is incredible. I've been playing one of the songs on repeat. It was like, it's got the cover of the foot on the ground and stuff.
Oh, yeah, 10 Toes. That was our latest
single. 10 Toes.
Yeah.
Oh, man, yes. I love it. You guys definitely check it out. Well, at the end, guys, we're going to bring everybody up here to kind of let you know how you can connect with them. We're going to have them all come up. We're going to do a bow, and then we're going to take a selfie together. So let's throw some confetti for Damien. Damien, thank you again for coming up here and sharing that song with us. We're going to bring Joel back up one more time. Joel's going to close out the night. Joel, would you come on up? And I think as long as nobody's done anything to him in the tour bus, that they might have him tied up or something. He's not out here yet. There he is. Okay, he made it. All right. I was just making sure. I was going to call you and make sure you're okay. So nobody's done anything weird to you yet? Well, I can't hear you. Uh-oh. Let's see.
Can you hear me now?
I got you now. Woo-hoo! Yes, I got
okay,
you.
Okay, I had it muted on purpose because I had to leave the tour bus, run on stage, play a song with another band, and run back in the tour bus, and now I'm back.
No, you did not. Gosh. Did you really?
I totally did. Oh my gosh.
Wow, okay. All right, you're dedicated.
I got a text, and they're like, we need you. And I was like, okay, I have like 2 minutes.
Oh my gosh, wow. Well, Joel, wow, you guys throw some confetti for that, man. Someone's working off his sugar cookies. I mean,
straight up ate some gluten-free Oreos. They're delicious, by the way.
Oh, that's great. Well, Joel, okay, I wanted to ask you to come up and do one song. You're going to close this up for us. And then you guys don't take off, because, again, we got to do some giveaways and stuff. Before we do giveaways, we're going to bring everybody back up to kind of just share how you can connect with them. But, Joel, I wanted to bring you up. I know you're going to do an original song, like one of your original Christmas songs, correct?
Yep. Yes.
Okay, I'm going to do that double jointed thing real quick, guys, because my headset is sliding down. So, you see, everybody that's watching online is like, what the heck is wrong with these people? I'm sorry, you're going to have to explain this to your friends. Okay, well, I know that for all of you, I know that, you know, I realize that Christmas isn't always easy for everyone. You know, we've been kind of hinting on that, talking about that a little bit during this Christmas experience event. But it's important. I think it's important. We've talked about this a lot at the studios, is taking time to slow down. And I want to encourage you that during this Christmas season, that you take some time to slow down and remember the true meaning of the season. Because all the other things that really doesn't align with the true meaning of the season can really weigh us down. So take some time and remember that. And I hope that I think slowing down and remembering that will help you find that joy. It might not solve all your problems in the season that you're going through, but it's going to bring joy to you. to remember what this season's about. And I love this song that you're going to do, because I think this song helps connect with us in that area. So yeah. Joel, if you please, if you want to tell them about your song, you feel free to share with them what, how this song came about. I'm going to step off, give the stage to you. And once you're done, I'll come back up.
Okay. Yeah. So, hopefully y'all can hear me. I'm getting straight in front of this microphone. So I wrote this song with my good friend Ross King, and it was, I guess, 4 years ago nearly, that the COVID Christmas was a thing. And by the way, I love that song, Damien, wherever you're at, the COVID Christmas, it had me cracking up. It's hilarious, and also kind of what we were all feeling. But this song we wrote during that season where it felt like everything was turned upside down, and you know, we had to really get back to what is Christmas really all about. Because I think over you know, I've been on the earth a lot of years, and over those years I feel like I have you know, kind of bought into the consumerisms of Christmas and forgotten about what it really truly is all about. You know, we all watch, maybe not all of us, but a lot of us watch the Peanuts Christmas and watch him tell the story of what Christmas is really about. And that's kind of the story that we had in our mind of, you know, Luke chapter 2, the story of Jesus being born, and getting back to that and remembering that God sent his son Jesus for us because he loved us, so that we could be made right with him. And that's the truly most amazing part of Christmas. Gifts and things like that are great. You know, hanging out with friends and family is an awesome part of Christmas, but the best part of Christmas is that Jesus was born. And the way we put it is like, that makes me feel like a kid on Christmas morning. So hopefully I don't forget all of my lyrics, because I can't see them with a headset on, but I will do my best. Forgive me, Ross. But anyway, the song is called Like a Kid on Christmas Morning. And also, I'm sorry, I dropped my pick running out of the bus and running back into the bus. So I am finger picking right now. Hopefully it's loud enough. So the song is called Like a Kid on Christmas Morning. Am I the only one who is struggling here to have an attitude full of Christmas cheer after the crazy kind of year we've had? Maybe it's the stress of the crowded stores and trying to buy gifts that I can't afford. I know the season's so much more than that, but I'm choosing here and now to see what this day is all about for me. 'Cause I still feel the wonder of that story, how you came down from heaven as a baby. And I'm still so amazed at your love for me. And when I think about it, even now I feel like a kid on Christmas morning. Ooh. I can see it all now in my memories. Waking up early, running to the tree, tearing that paper so that I can see my gifts. Then we would read Luke chapter 2 about Mary and Joseph and what they went through, and the infant king who would make things new again. And even though so many years have passed, in my heart I still hold on to that. 'Cause I still feel the wonder of that story, how you came down from heaven as a baby. And I'm still so amazed at your love for me. And when I think about it, even now I feel like a kid on Christmas morning. On Christmas morning. Cause I still feel the wonder of that story, how you came down from heaven as a baby. And I'm still so amazed.
ways that you love for me. And when I think about it, even now I feel like a kid, cause I still feel the wonder of that story. How you came down from heaven as a baby. And I'm still so amazed at your love for me. And when I think about it, even now I feel like a kid on Christmas morning.
Thank you. That was amazing. Thank you so much, Joel. Thank you so much.
Yeah, man. Thank you for having me.
I'm so glad to have you back. So happy. You guys, let's throw some confetti for Joel here. You made it all the way back from running back to the bus. I'm glad that you just lost your pick, so you're good. So you're good. Sounded great.
I had to play really hard.
Yeah, it sounded good. Thank you so much, Joel. You know what? You guys, just stay up here, Joel. I would love to bring up all the guests, all the artists that came up and sang tonight. Please come on. Just guys, run on down and jump up on the stage here. Let's everybody come up. And our volunteers, too. Dawn, Mrs. Killerby, come on over here. I would love for our volunteers, that's our moderators and stuff, come on down. And I would love for you guys, just everybody, like, when everybody gets up here, I would just love for you guys all, just throw some confetti for them. Like, this was a lot of work to put together, and we couldn't have done it without all of you. So we are so grateful, so thankful. And if we could, let's get the guests. Let's see. Okay, let me go ahead and let Pretty Gal first come up to the mic. Pretty Gal, and share how can people connect with you outside of Horizons. I know some of you have already shared, but I want to make sure I give everybody a chance to share that. Pretty Gal, how can they connect with you outside Horizons?
You can connect with me on Instagram. It's PrettyGal2_VR.
Awesome. Thank you, Pretty Gal. And Jay Fish, come on up to the mic. You come on up to like a letter by now. How can they connect with you outside of Horizons?
Hey, really easy. Jay Fish Meta on Instagram. All one word. If you want to say hi, I'm fairly new to the Instagram game. But
awesome.
Please be my friend. Please be my friend.
That's awesome. No begging. We're not ashamed to beg. All right, Pink Ice, come on up. Pink Ice Diamond, let us know, how can we connect with you again outside of Verizon?
You can connect with me on Instagram at Pink Ice Diamond VR.
Awesome. And then Damien, one more time. Damien, what's the best way for everybody to connect with you across social?
You can connect with me at Damien Horne. That's just my name on all socials, and also the Magi Music across all socials.
Yes, awesome. And then lastly, Joel, come up and let us know, how can we connect with you?
You can find me. That's a microphone. Yeah, you can find me on Instagram at Joel Vaughn Music, all one word. That's JoelVaughn. YouTube is Joel Vaughn Music. Facebook is Joel Vaughn Music. Everything is Joel Vaughn Music.
Joel Vaughn Music. Everything's Joel Vaughn Music.
That's awesome.
You guys, I'll throw some confetti again for them for one more time for coming out and being a part of this. Thank you guys all. If you guys want to jump off the stage for just a second, still hang around because we're about ready to wrap up. We're going to bring you all up here to give pictures of everybody. We'd love to get a picture of everybody. So, you know, again, I thank you guys all for coming out and being a part of it. I know that we've got people right now waiting for the contest. We're like, okay, well, how are we going to get, like, we got to do this contest thing. So, Mrs. Killer B, we're going to do the contest thing. You guys, again, if you guys want to connect with us, look, take a picture of the Discord right above us or right there on the producer board. We have a Discord. You can join it for free. We would love to get you guys in there to have a, you know, build up a community, have more activity going on. We're going to be using it a lot this next year. So easiest way, just go to discord.killerbstudios.com. It's a free invite. You can jump right in. Now, and you'll find out about the contest and all the new events coming up. So, Mrs. Killerby, we're going to do this contest. Now, I know sometimes we have some glitches on this, so that's why we wanted to do it after the show, because I might have to reset the world. So, all right. But the first thing we're going to do is we have to give away two headsets. So the people that's in the first 20 are on that list. So we're just going to pull the lever, and we're going to see who name comes up and see who wins that first headset. Now, again, we will ship these headsets out after the – you know, after New Year's, once we get the headsets back, we're going to be shipping them out to you guys, and they'll be yours to keep. So let me go back and actually make sure it's set right.
Okay.
It is set right. So I'm going to try. Dawn, can you try pushing that contest button? Let's see if it works. Aha, who will it be?
Woo-hoo!
Who wins the first headset? Who is it? It is Diener. Diener, let's throw some confetti for Diener. Awesome. Diener gets the first Oculus 2 headset. Now, if your name comes up twice, you can't win it. You can't win two, okay? So, all right, so let's go ahead and hit that button again, Don. Let's see who wins the second headset. Who wins that? Oh, let's try it again. Oh, I just got a notice. It said Kelly. Did you see it? Did anybody see the name? Did anybody see the name? Kelly.
I saw it.
You guys saw it. Okay. I didn't see it. So it did say Kelly. Awesome. Well,
Kelly D. Yeah.
Kelly D. Yes. Kelly D wins the second headset. So congrats, Kelly. All right. So I'm going to go back and reset the contest because now we have to give away. We're going to give away the $25 gift card to Amazon to somebody in here. Now, here's the way this is going to work. You get the full experience is what it's usually like during the show. So I got to go back and reset the contest. What you're going to do is we're going to do a drawing and whoever's name comes up there gets to come up and grab that whack-a-bee stick out of that case, and we'll bring up the gong for you to whack the gong, and then we're going to get your email, and we'll ship you that Amazon gift card. So give me just a second. Let me go back and reset the names.
And actually, we're not going to ship it to you. We're going to send it to you in your email, so it'll be a lot easier.
Oh, yeah, that's right. That's right. We're going to send it to you in your email. So with that, let's try hitting that contest button again. Let's see if it works. Okay, who will it be? Who will it be? And the winner of the $25 gift card is Lep77. Don, can you hit that guest music? Let's bring Lep, come on down and grab that wackabee stick. Come on down, Lep. All right, look at him decked out in his holiday swag right here. Come over here, Lep. We got to see this. Let's really take this in.
Isn't this a fancy outfit?
All right. Okay, can you show off this outfit? You got to spin all the way around like you're doing like a whole fashion show here. Like you got the Santa hat on.
And you have to step out of the way, Mr. KillerB, because you're blocking everybody. Okay, give us a fashion show, Lep. Let's see it.
Yeah, that's awesome. That's awesome. All right, Don, can you bring up the bee gong? And Lep, go over and whack that bee with all your holiday cheer. Yeah, right. There you go, Lep. You got 50 points. Plus, I'll get your email address, and we will get you that $25 gift card shipped out to Amazon. All right? Or emailed to you. So thank you so much, Lep. Thank you. Awesome, you guys. All right. You guys, again, thank you guys for coming out. Remember, next Tuesday. Next Tuesday coming up. Man, it's Mike. I'm sorry if I hit you with that mic. Sorry about that.
Nope, you didn't hit anybody.
You know what? Hey, Don, Don, hit the change set. So let's go ahead and bring up the table here so that we can get rid of this mic. All right. Try it one more time. Oh, it's not doing it. Oh, there we go. Okay, cool. All right. So what we're going to do is we're going to come down the floor here after we close out the show for getting a selfie all together. But remember, next Tuesday, we have our Christmas caroling spotlight. So please come out. Don right here is going to be actually leading us in some of the Christmas songs. She's going to get us started. Her and Dina will be hosting the event. So come out, take the stage, share a Christmas tune that holds dear to your heart. Let's just have some, what we said, let's spread some Christmas cheer together. So if you have Horizon friends that you know loves to sing, bring them up. Let's do some Christmas songs together and just have some more fun. You know, there's a lot of people in Horizons that I've ran into, Mrs. KillerB, that said that they don't have family outside anymore that they connect with, but this platform has allowed them a place to come to connect with people during the season, and it's really helped them during that season. So I love that.
Yeah,
so with that, let's go ahead and cue the outro music, and everybody come up, let's take a selfie.
Thank you for joining us today at KillerB Studios. Remember to text the word buzz. That's BUZZ to 863-262-7763. That's Buzz to 863-262-7763 for studio links. And don't forget to like the world. That's very important. We'll see you next time and have a killer day.
Awesome. All right, everybody, let's grab a good selfie together, and let's take one inside and then go outside. Everybody, anybody in here that doesn't know, if you just do a thumbs up, it'll make you smile, and then we'll grab a picture together. Everybody, let's give our smiles and say cheese, and then let's throw confetti by doing this, and 3, 2, 1, confetti!
Is Joel here?
Awesome. All right, so you guys, let's run outside and take one in front of the studio. I would love to get you guys outside, and you guys can hang around and talk. And I know some of your artists are going to have to go. Thank you guys all for coming out. And Joel's remember that, here. Joel's not here. He's probably got to go, I bet. About.
Let's see.
Thank you.